Good morning, everyone. Big Faze with Crappie Crushin TV and Lake Arthur Crappie Anglers. Today is what? March 25th, 2021. It is 8:22 in the morning. We got 52.5 degrees surface temperature. We're going to go after some brush crappies, shoot some more brush. Not looking for size, don't really care about size, looking for numbers today. So yeah, you stick with me, we're going to get on them. Fish. See how light that bite was? That's what I'm always talking about. Very light bite. It's a nice fish. Decent crappie there. Ain't bad. Nope. Decent little fish. Eater fish for someone eating them, you know. Oh, I didn't know if I was recording. There's a mini. Basically looking just for change in that slip floats behavior. I knew it. See where he pulled me right after that? That's a place I get stuck all the time. Yeah. That's why I said in my last video, I'm in, I'm out, I'm in, I'm out. Because they drag you right up in it. Throw it back up in there. The split shot may be a little too heavy. It's submerging that float a little too much, but I can still see, you know, what it's doing and what it's not, because we're just looking for that shift in movement pretty much. I think I gotta go deeper. Oh, don't you run after that branch out there. That's where I get hung up every time. Yeah, we're not deep enough. We gotta get down a little deeper. Let me slide this bobber stop up just about 5 inches. Let's see what happens now. Nothing. One thing nice about that bobber being a little heavy with that split, when they do that negative bite, it'll just come right up and float to the top. There's a good fish, man. That's a good fish, guys.
Look at him, man.
Good fish.
Good fish.
Don't you get that hook stuck in the net, fella. It's a decent fish. Enormous. Nice fish. See, what I'll tell you is when the bait can sit in there a little bit, that's when you get the bigger fish. Them little ones slap it up real quick, you don't get these nicer fish. This is a decent one. Toss her in there again. Oh, no, don't you run in there, boy. And a good set of polarized glasses is key, not only to see the fish, which I'm not really seeing now, but to see those underlying branches down there. You know what I mean? So you don't throw right into the mess. There we go. There we go. Oh, quick release. But yeah, I can see those branches down in there. So I'm not throwing it right into the mess. I'm sticking it right in between little forks things like that. Let it drop right down in there. Not back far enough, really. That danger zone's over there. There we go, though. There we go. Woo! Come on, buddy. We got some shoulders, man. Look at this fish. A nice fish, man. A nice fish.
Look out.
We're going to get a net off of him. Nice fish.
Oh, and we drug the hook into the net.
Boy, these rubber nets are nice.
They don't get jammed up.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about right there. The beauty. Put her in there again. Ooh, it's a lively mini. Gotta watch out that float closely. Don't let them drag me out into that snag neither. That's a lively mini. You gotta watch it closely. Just for, oh, don't you go, man. He wants to get me hung up. Throw him to the right a little bit more, see what happens. Can't leave him in there too long. That's what happens, and I missed him. Did you see that bite? That was a little better bite. I think I may be dropping down below him. Raise this up a little bit. I think it's moved. Be like that. See what that does. Winds are picking up. There was a fish on there. Small one. Wonder why. I thought that mini was running like that. Small little fish, guys. Oh. He wants to stay in the boat. Little guy. Back in there. Who's that? There's one. Oh. Well. Hey, now we're tangled up on the wrong line here. Let me get fixed up. Winds are starting to pick my rear end into the brush. I'm gonna have to reposition the boat here shortly. Otherwise, we're gonna get ourselves in some trouble like the other day. Winds are coming out of the south. I'd be right behind the camera. The boat's not positioned optimally for a south wind. Yeah, water's 52.2. I'm looking over there on the Hummingbird right now. 52.2, and I came out early today. Usually I'm waiting for later midday this early in the season, but only went down to like 48 degrees last night up here. So see them slackline that. See them slackline that. Good fish. You see them, that bobber just come up out of the water and laid over. It's a nice crappie. Real nice crappie. Oh yeah, real nice crappie. Bottom lip. A stud. Let's get him out of here. I'll show him to you. Yeah. Oh, camera's falling over. Look at that bad boy. Camera keeps falling over. Sorry. Yeah. Check that out. He's a nice one. Tiny mini on here this time. I don't know what that'll bring. But the key, like the last one, it had time to sit back there for a little bit. that's when them bigger fish have a chance to grab it. That was last one, was a nice 13 inch. He's swimming around there. Little as he is, he's moving that bobber around. Hope you guys can see. Got you on a tripod today on the GoPro. There we go. You dropped that down a little bit, huh? He's feisty. He's decent crappie. Little decent crappie. Heck yeah. Nothing to be ashamed of right there. Look at that. Nothing to be ashamed of at all. Cut my mini too. Yeah. Nothing to be ashamed of. 11 inch fish. Come here, buddy. I went out to the stern there and dipped off the other side of that branch. Got that nice one right there. Oh yeah. There we go. Ten inch crop. Nice little fish. Get me hooked. Got him in that bottom lip. A 10 inch fish. Not bad. Back down in there. Oh, buddy. Don't you have it for a minute? Yeah, he must have had it for a minute. I'm going to have to change this hook out, though, because my lead keeps slipping down, and that's screwing up the presentation. Smaller fish. But I'll get back with you here in a second. Hey, I want to show you something. I told you I fished this slime line. This is 4-pound high vis. There are days when this water's clear like it is, sun is shining like it is. I need to run fluorocarbon leader 4-pound, okay, because they're seeing that high vis and they're not wanting to hit the bait. Now guys will argue with me on that, okay, but I've proven it over the years. Some days you got to have that leader on there. I just proved it off camera. My leader got shorter because I broke off a few times. It was only down to about 7 inches. They weren't hitting it because they could see that knot up here. They can see that freaking slime line right there. They weren't touching it. So brought it in, tie a new leader on. First drop in, I just nailed a fish off camera because I had to change the battery. So yeah, and that's clear like it is, man. Guys will say I don't matter, I catch them like off. Well, I don't, okay? They see it, especially this early in the season. They see it and they won't touch it. Little guy there, ain't bad. Be good in someone's skillet. Yeah. Right there. Back down in there.